Burger.
See, that's why you check the women's section, because you come up on dope ass 1980s hair metal band t-shirts. Look at this thing, it's paper thin. Oh my God. That is a score right there.
What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. How crazy is that 80s shirt? There's more cool stuff that's gonna come along. I just wanna thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the notification bells. There's a lot of cool other finds in this. Also, I also found this 1983 Star Wars piggy bank that is gonna go to the collection next to my old ass Yoda. All right, enough of me. Let's get back to the video.
So I picked up that Europe band tee from 1980. I cannot believe I found that. That is insane. I found that Disney Imagineer Mickey's of Glendale vintage polo. And I found a Bush hat from the Golden State record with the tags on it. So, I can't, wow, what an amazing, like, you know what, I'm bored, I'm gonna go to the thrift store, kind of a trip. That's how it is, man. Sleep, you get the itch, you go. Bye.
All right, so yes, I did come up with these Turtle Dubs. I didn't get enough video footage of it because there was a kind of a lot of people around talking to me. So I was a real quick, fast snippet of that shoe. But I did find them, I did pick them up. Now, the reason I picked them up is because, you know, I did some research and I thought they were real and I really, really sat there for a while and really got down on it. As you can tell, the lines here go up a little bit too close for comfort for me, so. That was a telltale sign. On the inside, it did have the serial number on the insoles, but then I was completely lost, so I hit up Mick from Fresh from the Flea. His link's down below to his videos, one of the coolest thrifters on YouTube. I hit him up, sent him some pictures. We're Valley Boys, you know what I'm saying? Valley Boys gotta stick together. And it came down to the insoles, where he really knocked it home. I mean, look at those insoles. I didn't really know that trick about the insoles. He did, and unfortunately, they're not real, so they're gonna go back here as a prop. And then maybe I'll do a video of I burnt my Yeezys and people will click and watch. Let's get back to the video. So I found these Nikes, I can't pronounce the name, so I'm gonna go ahead and put the photo up here. These in a good condition and this size of 10.5 could go for $150 on StockX. Not in this condition whatsoever. As you can see, someone wore them to paint and there's paint all over this damn thing. But then I also found these cool grays. Now, $345 brand new on StockX. These are clearly used and not in pristine condition. So I'm gonna keep these for the personal because I don't own a pair of this particular model. So score for me. This shirt straight up reminds me of Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, like something they would have worn in that movie. Such a bitchin' shirt, but this Tigger corduroy? Fire, dude. I had to scoop this for sure. This is going in the personal as well. And then maybe I'll sell it once I'm tired of wearing it. But dude, sick. This piece is amazing.
It's a starter Lakers warm-up jacket. It's super big. It was like a triple XL. They wanted way too much money for it. Didn't make any sense to buy it, but I had to show it on camera because this is just too sick.
Walk out of there with a bunch of snapbacks and that Tigger corduroy button-up. I've been finding a lot of those corduroy button-ups lately. They are very scarce these days since they don't make them anymore as far as like that style.
So I just found this 1996 Rugrats. I didn't get these on camera, but when I ship out my clothing online, I like to use these as, you know, put a thank you on the back and ship them with these vintage cards. And I just came up on a whole slew of 90s vintage Marvel cards. So if you buy something from me, you're going to get one of these. All right, so far, not really much. I found this Cayman Islands shirt. It's got the shark on the sleeve right there. Just a cool print of a shirt. Found a kid size medium Harley shirt. Look at this print on this thing. It's so bitchin' long sleeve. And I also found a size small Harley Davidson with tags. Look at the back print on that. It's pretty amazing. Pretty epic. So I found these 2010 Griffies. I looked up on StockX, they go for like $200 something. But look at these. These are all falling apart. This kind of sucks. These are amazing shoes. Not to mention they're size 14. So I just found a really old vintage Atlanta Rhythm Section 1977 single stitched tee. Comps go for around $55 online, so I'm gonna grab this. So this thrift store, this stuff was behind the counter, so I really couldn't film, but I picked up this. This is my second like Micro Machines Star Wars thing that I picked up, but it's complete in a box. The comps online are insane, so I had to grab it. It was a little high for my taste, but selling it online will be amazing. I grabbed this G.I. Joe and this amazing Batman gyrocopter toy. Look at that. That's so bitchin'. Such a cool little piece. I paid $12.99 for this, but they go online for a good amount of money. So it was actually worth picking it up.